44th Halloween for 44 days, he gets to eat.
Eat what? Eat what?
Eat us.
Hey guys, it's Brittany, and welcome back to Brittyween 2020. Holy crap. Okay, first of all, I know that this is my old set from September, and I know this is my like first sit-down video for Brittyween. Actually, no, my first one was I think it was October 3rd, day 3, when I did my pendulum session, my first one with Jem in my Harley Quinn Birds of Prey costume. But I have not done a sit-down video. Usually when I open up Brittyween on the first day, I am in front of this brand new set for Halloween. This year has just been a completely different theme. It's very simple. You guys know Jeepers Creepers, and obviously this is not Jeepers Creepers, but honestly, I love this setup so much. And I know it's Britty Wise's lair from 2017, but I don't think she minds, and I think Britty Wise will be back for Brittyween, but I'm just having fun. It's just very simple, and you know, and Jeepers Creepers, and I did all of my investigations. I just like threw them out. I mean, there could be more coming. Now there's, you know, more, there might be like a potential lockdown happening in the future here, so I don't really know, but I just threw out all, oh, I didn't throw them out. I mean, I just poured them out onto Brittyween right in the beginning. Just boom, boom, boom. Investigation, investigation, investigation. So now we're getting more into the sit-down videos, more into the stories, like the scary stories, and more into the costumes, because I've only had one costume. Actually, no. Trish and Derry from Jeepers Creepers and Harley Quinn. And that's been it. And we are now on day 12, I think, as you were watching this. So now I am the bride, the killer bride, the demon bride from Annabelle Comes Home. I should also have a butcher's knife because that is what this bride has. So let's get into this story about this wedding dress that kills anybody. Actually, no. If you wear this wedding dress will make you kill your fiance. This is gonna be my wedding ring, my skull ring from Zach Bacon's Haunted Museum. This wedding dress has been linked to numerous deaths because the spirit takes over the wedding dress. Whoever wears it, it takes over that person, and it makes you murder your fiance or your groom, whatever. Now, in Annabelle Comes Home, that was literally the scariest scene, was the bride when she's walking so fast towards Judy with the knife, like that freaked me out more than anything in the movie. So when this dress, or is it this dress? Maybe I am wearing the actual wedding dress. Maybe I'm actually the dark entity, the demonic entity talking to you guys. Maybe that's why I don't have a Britty Wise or a Maybe that's why I'm in Britty Wise's lair. Because Britty Wise is the bride demon. So after this wedding gown is purchased, the bride possesses its new owner when she wears it, eventually driving her to stab her groom to death. A violent, bloody end to what should be the happiest day of their lives. The bloodstains will then disappear from the dress right after, so it can reel in a new victim and continue its cycle. Now, before Ed and Lorraine Warren were called in about this dress to investigate this dress, this demonic entity, this evil entity, already was behind 7 deaths involving women wearing this dress and then killing the groom, fiance. So what I think is really creepy is the fact that, you know, it gets all bloody, whoever wears it, and they kill their groom, and then it just disappears, and it just goes back, and it's for sale again. It just acts all normal. So maybe I'm wearing it, maybe I'm not. I'm not gonna tell you. Now, is this bride story real? Or was it just made up for the movie, or maybe exaggerated for the movie? Y'all, I'm starting to freak myself out in the viewfinder. What the heck? Maybe I should have I should get a butcher's knife and just hold it like this. I don't know. Well, there is a white dress that is present inside the Warren's Occult Museum. By the way, I did a whole video at the Warren's Occult Museum. Like, I was actually there. I met Annabelle. It was literally like the best day of my life. So definitely check it out if you haven't seen it yet, because like, holy crap, like I met the real Annabelle and I was like, it's such an honor to meet you. And I think Annabelle really liked me from the pictures and stuff. But if you haven't seen those videos yet, I have so many Annabelle videos, then check them out, because you guys know Annabelle is my fave. But getting back to the white dress that is present in the museum. Now, Tony Spera, he has said, he's kind of debunked it by saying that it's not known whether or not this dress that is in the museum was ever owned by a bride. So if it never belonged to a bride, then none of these murders even took place. Which is great, which is amazing, you know, we don't want murders to take place. But I'm just saying, none of the murders then took place. No possessed demon spirit, whatever, dark entity came through and took over whoever purchased the dress and stabbed all these people. Or did it happen? Maybe I'm not spirit. But Tony Spera says that the whole bride story was really made for Annabelle Comes Home. Now, what he does say is the white dress represents the white lady from the Union Cemetery. And guys, if you haven't seen my Union Cemetery video, I also went there and looked for the white lady myself. And I almost got arrested. Yeah, there was a police officer was watching me the whole time. It was quite something, but then I had to tell him, hey, this is my first time in Connecticut. I just wanted to experience the white lady myself. So definitely check out that video. It was a lot of fun. And if you are a big fan of Ed and Lorraine Warren, then you know about the white lady. She has been spotted for decades in the cemetery, just roaming around. But what do you guys think about this bride story? Do you think it's purely fiction? Or do you think it's real? Do you think they're covering it up? Well, according to Tony Spera, no. But I mean, you never know. There is another haunted wedding dress out there that I did make a video about a few years back, so definitely check out that video as well. It's another haunted wedding dress, which is just, it's very fascinating to me how spirits hold on to such items as a piece of clothing. They need to make a spin-off of this bride. That would do amazing, because she is freaky. The way she walks, and like, she's about to stab somebody. That was my way of stabbing somebody. I should really have a knife with me, but I don't think YouTube would allow that. Because when I was Susie's Got Your Number from Michael Jackson's Blood on the Dance Floor in my videos, I always had a knife, and YouTube didn't like that. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a like, share with your friends, and let me know down below if you would love to come to my wedding. All of you guys will be a part of my wedding. You'll be in my wedding party. Oh my god, how fun would that be? A brethren wedding? And y'all just walk down the aisle with me looking like a bunch of snakes. Like the good kind of snakes, like the Slytherin kind of snakes, not like an actual snake, like you know what I mean? Like an actual, like a cute snake, you know? Even though like snakes aren't that cute to me, they kind of freak me out. Actually, they're one of my biggest fears. Actually, I did hold a snake though at Zach's museum, which was quite amazing. But I was on cloud nine that day, so I felt powerful. I felt invincible, that I could I could do anything. And I really did do anything that I wanted to do. I couldn't believe it. Anyways, that is my mini Halloween story, because that happened in October, a year ago. Yeah, amazing. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know your thoughts down below about this demon bride. Do you really think it's me? Because I think I am the demon bride, actually. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. As always, you rock my world, and the song lyrics, Michael Jackson. Hashtag team, Britty44. Actually, I should have my wedding ring. This is my wedding ring. Hashtag team, Britty44. Hashtag for with the winds. Hey, and I will see you guys in my next video, which is tomorrow. Bye.